Get ready to match the stars.
Hey, everybody. Welcome to the match game. Oh, my gosh. And look at this. Everybody is here. There's Jeff Cecil. There's Tracy McCray in the role of Brett Summers. There's Logan Nielsen as whoever the comedian they always put in the left top corner. Oh, Charles Nelson.
you saw who I was choosing. Yeah.
There's Megan Kennedy as Betty White and Steve Lange as Richard Dawson.
What?
I mean, sorry, Mincy McCall. I'm sorry. You already told me that, and I was trying to spread it all out, but I didn't do it well. Anyway, that's folks.
Wasn't it Betty White that sat down there?
Yeah. Mincy.
I appreciate the Richard Dawson reference, though.
But it's either so. With you, either in that corner, you're either Betty White. That's where Mincy sat. Fanny Flagg always sat there too.
Fanny Flagg, yes.
You know, Logan is sitting where. Or Patty Deutsch would sit there sometimes as well. Megan is in the Richard Dawson spot until he got mad and left.
I'm going to kiss all of you on the lips the next time I see you. That's only thing I know about that guy.
That sounds like that's creepy.
He was good at match game, though.
He was. He was the best. Everybody always picked him for the big money match. anyway, folks. And Logan Nielsen down here in the corner where the hot girl always sat.
True. Right next to Richard Dawson.
All right. Good enough.
That's why I'm here.
All right. So, folks, if you're at
home. Signed it as Logan Nielsen Riley.
You could have. I mean, you know, what am I going to do?
I didn't think about it until I got here, John.
Okay. That's fair. All right. So, for those of you that are watching, I hope this is going to be fun. You can play along if you want to. Here's how it's going to work. What I've done is I went through all the old match game. Not all of them. A few of them. And so what we're going to do is I'm going to play Gene Rayburn playing the question. And then all of you guys can think of an answer. And I hope, Megan and Logan, you got some paper and a Sharpie or something that you can hold up your answer with. Megan is on it. Yeah. Logan, you can write it on a doll. Logan has a basement full of dolls, but anyway, that's a whole other story.
Well, if you phrase it that way, I don't have a basement full of dolls.
Anyway, so we'll come up with the answers and then we'll go back to the video of the contestant answering.
Okay.
And then we'll go through the whole panel with their answers. And the way our scoring will work is for every correct answer that you get, give yourself a point. If you also happen to get the same answer as the contestant, then give yourself a two times. So, for example, if the question is how many dogs fell in the blank and the answer none, zero. But the answer was well, and the contestant said well, and you said well, and Charles Nelson Logan said well, then you get 4 points instead of just two. Does that make sense?
There's no way I can keep track of all this.
Yeah. Sure you can. Sure you can. Sure you can. Yeah, totally full
of dolls. You already said you would do it, McCray. Don't back out now.
Yeah.
I'll try.
It's going to be easier than you think.
Okay.
Anyway, so is everybody ready?
There was a question. I don't know if you saw, but someone asked, completely full of dolls?
Yeah, that was for Logan. Logan, if you would have watched that show last week on Friday, yeah, it was completely full of dolls.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
The short version is I'm at my girlfriend's house. This used to be her grandma's house. Her grandma made and fixed old dolls. A lot of them look horrifying. That is the long and short of it. But
all right.
That's all you need to say.
So if everybody's ready, we'll start with question one. And let's see, there's Gene Rayburn right there. And I know he's sharp looking, isn't he? And here we go.
Sir Jeffrey was awfully afraid of getting blank in the jungle. Sir Jeffrey was deathly afraid of getting blank in the jungle.
Not the city.
D-E-O-F-F-E-R-Y, Jeffrey. You remember Sir Jeffrey?
Yes, I remember him well. Did he ever get rid of that?
All right. So Sir Jeffrey was deathly afraid of getting blank in the jungle. I should be playing that song, but I didn't. I have it just for the beginning. I don't have it for right now. Everyone have an answer?
Yes.
Yes.
Because I don't have lights.
Yes. Okay.
All right. So we'll go first to Jeff. Jeff, what is your answer?
Well, being a Jeff myself, I would be afraid to get humped.
All right, humped. That's a good answer. Tracy McCray, what is your answer?
I just figured the answer must be lost.
Lost. In the jungle. Gotcha.
Oh, gotcha. I misunderstood.
Yeah, don't worry. You'll catch up.
I don't Logan? Think you did.
You call me a Jeff?
Yes, Logan. What's your answer?
I said he was afraid to get mauled in the jungle.
Ah, very nice. All right, Megan Kennedy.
I said malaria.
Malaria. Very nice.
I had to get the good one.
And Steve Mitzi McCall.
I had a question about the rating of the show, but it was taken care of pretty early by Cecil there. So what I bitten by a snake.
Bitten by
I know now what kind of answers I need to give going
forward. I'm going in the wrong jungle.
There you go. Oh my God. Excellent. All right, folks. Perfect. And let me get down to our answer here. And I will let you know what the answer is.
Sir Jeffrey was deathly afraid of getting blank in the jungle. What do you say?
Attacked.
Attacked in the jungle. Attacked in the jungle. Let's see what you say about
it. I'm gonna put the man had an attack of malaria.
Malaria. Brett, what do you say?
I think I'm getting old. I think sex has become just a gender to me. I said malaria.
Malaria.
Oh, my God, Megan.
Attacked by an animal, I
guess. Oh, I thought you meant...
Oh, I see. Oh, no.
Gender attacked.
Yeah. Not Sir Jeffrey. You never...
I don't rage you. Don't care, animal. Attack him with the gender. Malaria.
Malaria. Everybody says malaria so far. What do you say, Joanne?
Well, I always heard when you went to the jungle, you always got malaria.
Yep. I guess that's the answer so far. Mr. Nielsen, you knew Sir Jeffrey.
On me.
Oh my
you
God!
A beautiful human being, and I'm not just saying that. He was bitten in the jungle. That's just above the fetlock. I'm sure you read it.
What? Did I get that?
Above the fetlock.
There he goes. No match.
Yes.
And Pat Carroll.
And since I knew Sir Jeffrey along with Richard, he was bitten by a bug that gave him malaria.
Malaria.
Wow. Wow,
apparently
wow,
they were
wow.
afraid of malaria in the 70s.
Holy cow. So it looks like Megan has scored 5 points. Is that correct?
That's what I've got.
Wow, Megan.
Do
very
I get,
nice.
Do I get one for bitten?
Did you say bitten?
I would say yes, yeah.
All right.
He said bitten by a snake.
Yeah. Okay.
Works.
Okay. I got you. Oops. Let me change the score. I'll give Steve a point.
Oh God.
I know. I'm just getting here. All right. And there we go. So folks, we'll run the score ticker across the bottom here. Jeff. Nice. Jeff, I mean, I wish I could give you a bonus point for humped because that was pretty good. But
thank you.
It's not it wasn't in the rules. There we go.
No.
I don't know where Logan went.
He disappeared.
Oh, here he comes. Here he comes. He had to get it because I believe he probably had to get a glass of beer.
He had to get another PBR.
Absolutely. All right. So I'm just going to pop up one here.
I had to,
Zach Ashton.
I had to shift to get better internet.
There you go. He was afraid to get feelings in the jungle, which is actually a pretty good one. So, folks, if you want to pop in your answer, go ahead and do it. We'll check them out after each round. And that was very good. So congratulations to you, Megan.
Way to go, babe. Right.
Yeah. Nice job.
I'm done playing around.
I let's go for the win, baby. All right.
I'm gonna be conspiracy out the front. She's seen this one. She knew it was malaria.
I've never seen any match games. I was actually terrified of this because I was like, I don't know if I'm supposed to be funny or try to win it. But I don't know if they're, you know, like if I'm supposed to be like the most logical answer.
Now we have to do what Brett always would do and go.
Yep, tear up your answer and throw it at Charles.
Shit, mine's a new phone though. Oh God,
man, don't do that. Well, you got to get right answers, huh?
Shit.
All right,
hold on, let me go borrow my girlfriend's phone now. No.
Perfect. All right, here we go, folks, with question number two, and bingo.
It was a very cheap airline. The airplane didn't have any blank. It was a very cheap airline. The airplane didn't have any.
All right. Cheap airplane. Cheap airline. Airplane did not have any blank. I got a feeling that's an inside joke, Megan.
Yeah, she says if we were Destiny's Child, she'd be Beyonce and I'd be Michelle because Michelle's the one that's always off step and falls off the stage.
Nice. All right.
You should be more insulted than you are by that.
No, it actually fits. Listen, oh, my God. My roommate's kid is here. Nat, come say hi.
Were they laying on the floor all that time?
I thought there was a killer in the background, but I didn't want to say anything. Just in case it was.
Crept in there. Oh my gosh.
Okay.
Well, way to photobomb a match game. All right.
When Megan was facing us, that person was whispering, "Help me."
All right. It was a cheap airline. The airplane did not have any blank, Jeff.
I'm afraid to fly. So yes. I've always had a fear of my plane not having wings.
Wings? Very nice. Wings is a good answer. How about you, Tracy?
I'm going to go with windows.
All right. Windows works.
That's disappointing.
Logan, how about you?
Well, when I travel, I like to sit at the front of the plane, but this one didn't have any separators because it had no class.
You get a point for that. I mean, you get a point for that. You're not going to match anybody, but you get a point for
no,
it.
No, absolutely not.
Oh, my gosh.
Was Paul right. Lynn a match game?
I kind of took Charles Nelson Reilly and made him Paul Lynn, I think.
Oh, my God.
You square for the block, I guess.
Oh, my God.
That together would work like this.
I just matched them and Rip Taylor all into one person.
Yes. Yes.
So beautiful.
My dream journal.
Oh, my God. All right, Megan, how about you?
I said wings.
Wings, another wing. Mitzi McCall, how about you?
I think it's malaria. So,
engines. Malaria. Beautiful.
Times are hard. He has to double side the card. That's tough.
Beautiful. All right. Let me pop up a letter here. There's my mother. She says, oops, I can't do that right now. Okay. I'll just play the answer here, folks. And keep track of your scores.
It was a very cheap airline. The airplane didn't have any
seat belts.
No. Boy, that's really all too far.
That was actually my real answer, but I couldn't use a class.
All close.
This would be very awkward, but it wasn't there. They didn't have any seats.
I mean, everybody just stood shoulder to shoulder. And...
Well, they had little straps.
I see. Brett, what did the airplane?
I said the airplane didn't have any wings.
No.
Oh, lots of wing answers.
That's right. The airplane didn't have any nightgown. That would be a better answer than no wings. What do you say, Jack?
Look, I'm
falling apart. Can we pass on?
Could you sew that up?
Could you pass on? I said.
Come on, folks.
No motor.
No motor.
There's an engine.
Seatbelts is what she wants. Joanne, what have you got?
I have half of it. I have seats.
All right, no match there. Close, Richard.
Yeah, they didn't have any motors, and the way they flew at a given signal, everybody.
Oh, as I said, they just cut. And then off into the water.
Well, flew yonder.
Oh, I see. Okay. That's what
you said. Most of the airlines I've been on, if you have enough of this, you don't need the seats, the motor, or anything else. Liquor.
No. Ah. No liquor.
Very nice. All right. So.
Who is Pat? I don't recognize Pat at all.
I can't think of her last name, but she was
McGroin.
Pat McCall. Pat, did you say Pat McGroin? That's as good an answer as I figure we need. Pat McGroin. All right. So, whoops.
Jesus.
There's a scores. Let me edit the scores now. So, Jeff, you said wings. Did you get two for wings? Was that it?
I had one.
There's just one wings.
One wing. All right. Steve had two motors. So he gets to bump up to three. Megan, you had a wing?
Yes.
All right. You move up to six. Tracy, you're still at nothing. And Logan, I'm going to give you a star because that was a good answer.
Stars translate the points here. I want
to. Well, they really don't, but I just want to acknowledge that was pretty good.
Yeah, okay.
Tear it up. Okay, so let's go back here, and my dear sweet mother said seats, so she got a point, or 2 points. Alex said pilots, as did Danielle. So there you go. Nice job. Pardon me.
I said good job, Danielle.
Yeah, good. Well, good job to everybody. You know, this is okay. So, what do you think? Is this
though with the windows thing?
Terrible. I got nothing. I feel like I'm looking at the headlights, like deer in the headlights. As soon as I'm like, think of something. I need to get some margaritas up here.
We say there are no bad answers, but
clearly there are.
I'm gonna head downstairs for the margarita to show up.
Listen.
I would. Okay. All right.
My immediate first thought was seatbelt, and I chose to pick a worse answer.
You went for the funny.
I talked myself into being worse at the game.
You went for the funny, though. Way to go, Megan. You got a fan. Megan has a fan. She's ahead. Big deal. It's beautiful. All right.
He's mad at the game he asked us to play. I love that.
I am not mad at the game. I'm just mad that I... Here's the thing. So look. Here's the thing. I'm not mad at the game. I'm just always mad at Megan. Megan always has to win everything. Anything I'm involved in, Megan has to try to win it. You know? Steve is not doing bad. Steve has got three. He's in second place.
It's my daughter. I don't think you should be watching this, Emma. The first answer was entirely inappropriate for what you should be seeing on.
This is fun. I like this.
How old is your daughter, Steve?
She's 13. So
yeah. Jeff ruined it for everyone.
Oh, well, that's not good.
All right.
I'll edit my answers.
No,
you don't need to.
You feel free to go crazy.
Don't edit them
out.
Don't go
crazy though. Like
yeah, I mean
teenagers definitely aren't saying words like hump. You know that.
Absolutely. No. All right, folks. Here comes question number three. And bingo.
Little Red Riding Hood said to the wolf, "If you're really my grandmother, show me your blank."
Oh Lord.
If you're really my grandmother, show me your blank.
Don't talk to me
about the easy way. Yeah, that's Jack Klugman right there thinking about what Jeff's going to answer.
I can't think of anything that's even remotely appropriate.
Well, sometimes you just got to go for it, you know?
I can't be worse than Jeff, though, at that. Like, I can't be like, oh, Megan crossed the line so much further.
Whitney says everybody's mad at you, Megan. So yeah. Jennifer says boobs.
Oh.
Jennifer said it first.
That was the audience. So there's your bar, Jeff.
They started it.
My mother says teeth. Anyway, we'll get back all those answers. Jeff, do you have an answer, or are you still writing a long one? Doll collection in your basement. Show me the doll collection in your basement. You can be as appropriate or not as you want, Jennifer. We're just having fun. Are you done, Jeff?
Yeah. Hold on 1 second.
All right. You're Logan.
That's my mom.
Your mom thought boobs. My mom thought teeth, and your mom thought boobs. I guess there's a generational difference there.
Yeah, I guess there it is. Yeah.
You're really a wolf.
All right, Jeff. We go to you for an answer. I like how you did that. He did it in a way.
Same answer, different angle. I like it.
It was subtle. There was some delicacy with Saggers.
there is nothing delicate about Saggers.
Yeah. I think it was.
Hard disagree on that.
Tracy McCray, how about you? Dentures. Very nice. Logan O'Reilly.
Well, I thought about putting Social Security card, but instead I went with eyes.
Eyes. Very nice. Megan Kennedy.
I still don't like my answer, but I said cookies. Like, because grandma's bake.
Is that a euphemism?
No, I said because grandma's bake.
Thanks for clearing that up for us, Megan.
Is that like crunchy Saggers?
Yeah. You spelled anyway. Cooter wrong.
I like the mint Saggers best, yeah.
Tag-a-sags. We go to Steve Lang.
Sagalongs, yeah.
First of all, I thought Logan was doing every answer as Katherine Hepburn in On Golden Pond. So, is he not doing that?
Okay, Steve, we're going to get on that horse and ride.
Yes.
Check. Get the Steve. Shotgun rooster.
Oh, my God. This couldn't be any better right now. And I mean that sincerely. All right, folks. Here we come with the answer.
Little Red Riding Hood said to the wolf, if you're really my grandmother, show me your
teeth.
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 Come on.
This is T-E-T-H. Teeth. All right, Bob, what do you say?
Teeth.
Teeth, it is. Okay. What did you find?
How about you kids think I said teeth?
No, I don't. I said
nightgown. I was nightgown.
I was gonna say nightgown.
All right.
Honey, yeah. I'm ashamed.
Don't be ashamed. We got
say.
Two dummies here. I said
teeth. Oh, boy.
Oh, Quincy.
He said bravo.
Oh,
can you believe that?
No, I can't. That's cute, but dumb. Very
good. May we see yours?
Of course. Here. I know all those things by heart. It's teeth.
Teeth. John, you got another match. You're up to two now. All right, Richard.
You're absolutely right. It is teeth, unfortunately. I thought it was wedding dress. I feel a bit embarrassed.
Wow, I thought Dawson would have the back.
Show us your muscles.
Yes, all right, John Stern's looking for the answer, teeth, and it's up to Pat Carroll.
Oh, here's to our damn teeth.
Teeth.
Hey. Okay. She was trying to do a Logan Nielsen there.
She was. That girl.
Oh my gosh. All right. So let's get to the scores.
Trying to do a Catherine Lind impression.
There you go. All right. So
do I get teeth for dentures, or does that account?
Nah, you know what? I'll give it to you just because I feel bad for you.
So
no Saggers for Jeff. How many teeth were there, Tracy? Three?
Two.
Three. Two.
Three
teeth. So Tracy got three. What yours was an inappropriate answer, right, Logan?
No, mine was eyes.
Oh, yours was eyes. What the fuck? Okay. Megan, what did you have?
Cookies.
Oh, yeah, cookies. So nothing for you. And Steve was chest. So it looks like on this one, Tracy was the only one that scored. And good for you, drinking team 2020. Nice job. But we'll go here, and I'll go back. Yes, out of the audience, my dear sweet old mother said teeth, only because she was about, I don't know, how old were you in the 1970s, Mom? Were you like,
she's on fire. I want her to text me answers.
28. Yeah, she can do it. She'll also text you some emojis. Go, Tracy, go.
Okay.
All right.
I'm trying, Danielle.
My gosh. So let me ask you guys, so far, is this okay? Are we having fun?
Yeah.
I love it. Yeah.
All right. Good.
It's good.
I'm disappointed that you counted dentures for teeth, but sure, besides that, it's been
you
fun.
Want me to count chest for teeth? I'll count chest for teeth, too, if I mean, if you really, I mean. I
no,
mean,
it's a problem. We're more raunchy than the crew that's in the panel of Match in 73. So.
Well, in 73, they were, I mean, I kind of feel like they were a little bit.
Drunk?
Yeah.
Well, I'm sorry they were, because they.
Less drunk than 75 and 76, for sure.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Mondays were always boring because that was the first one that they recorded. But by the time they got to Fridays, they had recorded five shows and everybody was drunk.
Mm-hmm. Ah, I didn't realize a lot of the esoterica behind Match Game 73, but
right.
Well, it's
I know that's not true.
It's good to know because Tracy is pretty much a Match Game scholar.
Oh,
what was that?
I'm ready to win this thing.
All right. All right. Given that fact, here comes the next question, folks. And again,
I
folks,
we're going to have a cover band called the Saggers.
How about the crunchy Saggers sounds
man,
better to me.
Man, no, I saw the Saggers last night. Those guys really swing.
That's what I'm talking about.
All right. Here comes the next question, guys.
The lady on the phone snapped. Mr. Cohen. At noon tomorrow, we cut off your blank.
Oh, yeah.
Lady on the phone. Mr. Cohen, at noon tomorrow, we cut off your blank.
Oh, my gosh.
And she's on the foot.
Yeah, we cut off your blank.
Yes.
I let that one go a little bit extra long, I guess. But the at noon tomorrow we cut off your blank.
Was Jeff, he saying this to?
Pardon me?
Was he saying this to?
A lady on the phone called and said at noon tomorrow we
Mister,
cut off
Mr. Somebody.
Mr.
Cecil.
Mr. Cecil, at noon tomorrow we cut off your blank.
I've all been married 24 years, so.
Where is Mary?
Mine were cut off a
Mary
long time
Russell, ago. Help me. Help me, Mary
oh,
Russell.
Oh, my gosh. Oh, my gosh. Somebody misses you, Megan. And plus, you're still ahead, so we're still mad at you. All right. Everybody got an answer. Jeff.
Ooh.
I went with Saggers again.
Oh, my God.
It could work.
Is that your real answer?
Yeah, you don't want to see my other one.
Well, Danielle Olsen says ding-a-ling, so I think he can get away with it. I think he can get away with it. Tracy, what do you got?
Well, I'll go with Danielle and with Mary, and I'll go with phone.
Oh, my. Excellent.
Because I want to win.
Yeah, my mom is afraid to say the answer she likes because she's a conservative lady. Logan, how about you?
I said internet. Oh, wait, it's 78. Damn it. Damn it.
You never know. Hang in there.
Got to take your first response. All right, Megan?
Electricity.
Electricity, very nice. Steve, what do you think?
That's the real answer, yeah.
I know I'm really confused now with the 1973 thing, but I before E, right? So I put Wiener.
I.E. ding-a-ling.
I before E, except after C, except like words is neighbor and Wiener.
Oh my gosh. All right, folks, here comes our answer.
Lady on the phone said, Mr. Cohen, at noon tomorrow, we cut off your blank.
Telephone.
Oh,
wow.
Telephone.
It was the first choice, yes. I said water. Cut off your water. Okay. He thought of telephone and he put water. Dave, all right.
Why did you think of water when it was a person on the phone?
Well, he could have been cutting off his water.
Look at this. Let's have this. Clarence Darrow, give the answer.
Okay.
Cut off.
Moving my long breath.
The lady on the, and I've talked to those ladies on the phone. Cut off your service.
All right.
No. Doesn't that match?
No, because it's telephone gas service or something else.
Oh, yeah. No, they only call it phone service, Jake.
Electricity. No match. Telephone is our answer. What do you say, George?
I was just told that on the phone the other week, and it happened. They cut off our electricity.
Electricity. Uh-huh. Gotta pay your bills. That's it.
What? It's free. Yeah.
Richard?
The lady actually said, we're going to cut off the water. And he said, do you have any advice? She said, cut down on fluids. Had to be there.
Okay, Pat.
The only people who have any service left to call you to tell you they're cutting it off is the phone company.
There
it is. All right.
This is kind of a dark joke, maybe not funny, but I do love that Robert Wagner said water and he's suspected of drowning Natalie Wood. Yeah. Anyway.
Actually, it's Robert Culp and he didn't drown nobody.
Is that Culp? That's like Robert Wagner.
Yeah. Okay. I mean, you know, it's okay, though. I mean, you're a young kid. You don't know.
He's murdered a couple of people on Columbo, so that's how I know him.
Oh, that's right.
He's a two-time murderer on Columbo.
All right, so Jeff Saggers
he
is
a murdered his career when he went on Columbo.
Saggers is a non-winning question. Tracy, how many phones did you get?
I think was there two or was there three?
I think there was. I don't remember. I think two. Two?
Two? I think it was. Wasn't it the contestant?
But
and
she
then
got
Pat?
The contestant. She should get 4 points.
Oh, that's right.
That was the two she got. Was the contestant and Pat?
The contestant. Yes, and, oh gosh, yes. Very nice, Logan. Nothing. Megan, you had electricity?
Yes.
And how many were there? Three?
I think I totaled
two electricities. Yeah, two.
All total, right. I should have 8 points.
Yep. And Steve, I can't remember what yours was.
I said wiener.
an electrical wiener.
I just have to say, if this was match game 74 or 75, I would have matched every answer.
Yeah, well, you know, service should be a point for internet.
Oh,
ooh.
Yeah, well, we go to the judges, and the judges say,
John, my mommy says I should get a point. That's what my mom thinks.
Well, all right. So that's not gonna happen. Anyway,
she comes to my shows and tells people to laugh.
My margarita. What?
No. All right. So, folks, here we go. Let me get that one out of the way, and we will go now to our next question. And it just takes me a little bit of time because I'm there. We go.
Enjoy, and here we
Raquel. Lost all her money in the poker game, so she bet her blank.
All right. Raquel lost all her money in the poker game, so she bet her blank. That's, Jeff, you could use that same answer again. Kelly Campbell says, brah. I'll go ahead and pop those in case some of you are having a hard time. Jennifer says, booty.
Nice.
Booty. Is that like pirate's booty or booty? Anyway, have you got an answer there, Jeffrey?
Yeah, I'm going to go, with something from maybe around 73, 74.
All right.
Say blouse.
Oh. Let's better blouse. I like it. Right. And Tracy McCray. Boobs.
Oh.
Boobs.
This is inappropriate, Tracy.
She's disgusting. Boobs. I swear she will.
All right. Logan Nielsen.
I wanted to get a point for matching Jeff, so. Do we not get points off each other? Does that not know how it works?
No. But keep going. Megan Kennedy.
I said clothes.
Clothes. Very nice. And Steve also says clothes. All right.
And Megan texted me.
Yes.
Right. You guys
we were
are right
watching
next
that show last night.
You guys are right next to each other, so don't cheat, right? All right. Here we go. And here comes the answer.
Raquel lost all her money.
So she bet her blank.
Her clothes.
Her clothes.
That should count.
We understand better.
Clothes, and we'll call on Brett first.
Well, there's an enormous amount of difference between strip and clothes.
Yes. Strip is not even a noun.
Does Raquel wear underwear?
Underwear. next time.
Whoa.
No, clothes is, no, it can't match that.
Maybe he'd like to sew on my sleeve.
Yeah.
Jewelry. And I don't mean the kinds of
match there. And we go to Richard Dawson.
Well, I happen to know when she was in Mexico filming, she was given a burro, so she...
Oh my gosh.
Jennifer Rand would have gotten a point.
She would have.
Moving along as quickly as we can.
Oh my goodness. Okay. So that was a wild and woolly scoring round there. All right.
I was
so
gonna say ass.
Okay.
Well, Megan and Steve got it right.
So Megan and Steve both got clothes. So you get 1 point for the clothes. Did but nobody else said point. So you get 2 points.
Because
it was a contestant in your match. So
Megan. Oh, it's time to go.
Five. Nice. I love it. I love it. That's beautiful. Megan goes to 10 points because she's not taking any. And what did you say, Tracy? Boobs?
I said boobs.
That's you said disgusting. Boobs. So it's there was no win for boobs. But very good. Very good. So there's our scores. Right now, Megan is in front with 10 points. Tracy has 7. Steve has 5. Jeff has 1. And Logan has a gold star for best best answer.
I have a participation trophy.
Well, right now, yeah. You know, holy cats. Let's see if anybody else has anything here. Alex would have got something with the tennis bracelet. Jennifer Rand bet her booty and won. And my old mama was going to bet her jewelry, too. So, very nice. Gosh, you guys, this is going along so well. I hope you're enjoying it as much as I am. And if you're not, I don't give a shit. All right. This, folks, is the... Here's the thing, now. This is the last question that I have lined up. Because I thought this would be about the right time.
Okay.
So, this will be the last question. This is the last chance for people to catch up. And what we're going to do is...
I'm going to win it, John. I'm really going to get it this time.
Here's why. As a like a administrative call, all points are doubled.
Ooh.
So everything. So now you could get 2 points, and now you could get 4 points because I want it to be exciting at the end. Okay?
Ooh.
It's so exciting.
It's not that exciting, but it's something. All right. So
it's
here we
go. It's the highlight of my day so far.
Well, okay. Here we go. Are they saggers? Last question. Here it comes.
Psychiatrist said to his secretary, "My next patient thinks he's a dog. So whatever you do, don't act like a blank." Psychiatrist is speaking to the secretary. Got it?
Of course I don't have it. If I had it, I wouldn't be here.
There you go. Brett would not be here, ladies and gentlemen, if it wasn't for Jack Klugman. Actually, did you know that? That Brett never would have been on the show if it wasn't for Jack Klugman. They asked him to be on it first, and he said, "Hey, would you have my wife come on?" And she was on, and, you know, obviously turned out better than him. He was Quincy, and she was just there in the middle with her. Anyway. Tracy should have known that. You're right.
Sure Tracy knew that.
Probably did. All right. So here we got a couple of fire hydrants as answered. Danielle and Kelly say fire hydrant. That's a pretty good answer. Jeff, what's your answer?
Well, you know how dogs are.
Yes.
So I said butthole.
Can you pull that paper back up again? Are you tearing the bottoms off like you're billing? What is that?
No, this is old printer paper that I recycle.
Oh my gosh, very nice. Tracy McCray.
Finally.
But now at the end of the game, now you'll get liquored up. She says fire hydrant. I'll throw this in her. Alex Wendorf says that, but Logan.
you brought that comment up a little too
just
early.
A little too soon. A little too soon. I'm sorry, but it still counts. Early. It still counts. Megan Kennedy, what's your answer?
I came so close to saying bitch too, but instead I went with cat.
Cat. All right.
I want you to know I had bitch and I was ready to delete it in case Jeff put it up first. Like I was ready.
I had it written down, but I decided to go with cat.
Very nice. Very nice.
Like, if anyone beats me to it, it'll be Jeff.
I put that poor woman on Megan's floor.
Fire hydrant. Beautiful. That's. I love it. So awesome. So awesome. All right. So Alex said bitch. Kelly said bone. My mom said dog. Okay, mom. Time for Nat. Time to go to bed, ma. You're not catching it. Anyway. All right. So here comes the answer, folks, and we will see who the winner is. And after this, there you go.
The psychiatrist said to his secretary, my next patient thinks he's a dog, so whatever you do, don't act like a blank.
Cat.
Cat is her answer. Let's see if she scores with that. Stu, may we see your answer?
Well, I had something a bit different in mind because since he was leaving, I thought that he shouldn't act like a tree.
A tree. Don't pose as a tree. With big branches. Okay, Brett, what do you say?
Well, I say that Jack Klugman chose to room with Richard Dawson as opposed to me. That's a true thing.
It is.
Yes.
I'm sick about it.
Now, you have to give that a lot of I said cat.
Cat. All right. So you score with that, Deborah. You have a little rebuttal there and an answer for us?
The difference in hair.
He said tree. Tree and plant. Is that
name 87?
All right, Stephanie, what do you say?
Well, I'm confused. I thought I'd think more like a girl who works most often as a secretary, because I do too, than I would like the fellas. But I chose the word tree.
Tree. Yes. Okay. Oh. All right, what is the sage one with a little bit of fuzz under his nose?
Come on, buddy.
Well, that's great. I said, whatever you do, don't act like a bitch.
Nice!
Okay. Don't act like a female dog. Right, a lady dog.
It's a technical term.
Yes. Okay.
So walk this for me.
Betty, her answer is cat.
Well, everybody else is barking up the wrong tree because I think it's cat.
Cat. So you scored twice with that.
I had Betty saying butthole. I figured she would.
She was. If anybody was going to do it, it was going to be her, huh? All right.
No, that's the back door, Betty.
All right.
I wanted to hear say butthole more than Betty White.
So, Jeff, you got nothing for butthole.
Damn it.
Steve, you said fire hydrant, yes?
I did. Both of us did.
Both of you said that, so you got nothing. Megan, did you say cat?
I did. I got 8 points.
You got 8 points total.
Mm-hmm. For that round.
Yeah, you did. Good for you. And Logan, you got?
I got two for bitch.
Two for a bitch. Excellent. All right. That's perfect. And now here are our final scores, ladies and gentlemen. The winner tonight is Megan Kennedy with 18 points.
Thank you.
Congratulations. Congratulations. Tracy is second with 7. Steve has 5. Logan pulls out of last place with his bitch.
Jeff, let her look up your shirt for winning.
Huh? I didn't understand what you said.
Because last time, Jeff, one of us, he was below me, so I held up my shirt and he looked at my shirt.
Oh, yeah. Go ahead. Let her give her a peek there, Jeff.
I was a bit looking down.
This is the band I'm going to be performing with this weekend.
Saggers and Wieners are at Kathy's?
Yes.
That'll be awesome. That'll be awesome. All right, folks. Now, I'm just curious. I just want to know, did you guys have fun doing this?
Absolutely.
Yeah. It was fun. Yeah.
All right. And audience, okay. Did you have fun watching? I know there's a little bit of a delay. Because if you had fun watching, we'll do it again. I don't know if I can do it every week because it's like it's a little work to go through all those things because you know what? Some of them just don't lend themselves to what we're doing. Nah, I don't know. They all do. Logan scores. Yes, finally Logan gets a score. Jen, Danielle loved it. That's awesome. I appreciate it very much. Okay, guys. So what do you think? Would you like to do this again in a couple of weeks?
I'd love to.
Yes.
I'm in. Yeah, great job, John. And if we helped one person here, and I think we did with the woman on Megan's floor. I mean, so if someone knows.
Yeah,
yeah.
Yeah, we did.
Here's the good news.
Yeah, we gave that young lady an opportunity to escape, which was really nice of us. So
the good news for her is I'm moving on Saturday, so then she doesn't have to stay locked in the basement. She'll be able to be throughout the rest of the home. So
excellent.
Is it a crawl space?
My poor next roommate, I'm going to make him crawl along.
My gosh.
Wow, that's a different kind of arrangement, I think. That's, out of the zip. When you said roommate, I think you meant sub. Anyway.
do they make you pay rent, Megan? Or do you get that for services?
Yes, we all can. Whoa, in the end.
Ultimately.
Yes, I pay rent.
There you go. There you go. Well, folks, gosh, I can't thank you enough for coming and doing this with me. It was a lot of fun. I felt like it was fun.
This is wonderful.
Hey, good job, John.
And
so do you send out a check then, or how does this work?
Yep, look for it.
Is my trophy going to be, like, are you going to get this and the hair trophy both shipped at the same time to save yourself on shipping, or how does that?
There's no trophy.
Hair trophy sounds like a slang for something.
So that's a long story that you don't know, Jeff.
It's not a long story.
I don't want to know it. I'm good. No, I'm good. I don't want to know it.
This is always. See, there's always been this point of contention. Between Megan and I.
Jealousy.
Thanks for looking in, Jenny. We appreciate it. And your son did great. He had the answers that mattered when they mattered. But Megan and I have always had this competition. And it's always been born out of the fact that Megan wins stuff for absolutely no reason.
I know, like because in this one, she had all the right answers. Like, no reason.
I know. It's just like,
unfair. What? She and got I'm them like, all right.
And I think to myself, beginner's luck. You know, I never watched the match game. Of course, she had to say that in the beginning, didn't
yeah,
she?
Yeah, right. I didn't even know what a match game is. I didn't even know what a TV is.
I was born in the 80s.
The 70s sweater gave it away.
Anyway, Steve Lange. Thank you so much for joining us. You were our local huge celebrity.
Yes.
I think that goes unsaid, John.
I you know, in fact, you know what? Because I feel so good about the fact you were here, I'm going to send you Jeff's check too.
Oh, nice.
Hey,
nobody watching knows who I am.
That's not true.
Your daughter does. Your daughter's in there.
You in comments.
Looking in the eyes again after I wrote wiener on a piece of paper.
But this has been great. So, folks, let's plan on it again in a couple of weeks. Otherwise, you can watch me interviewing people. Logan, you're going to be with me tomorrow at 1?
Mm-hmm. I'll be there.
All right. So tomorrow at 1, and remember, bring something to drink with you, like a bottle of wine.
Right. Oh, my God. John got so drunk last Friday.
It's going to be, that's nice. Ooh. Red ale, you got it.
Ran out of beer.
Yeah. So we'll be drinking. We'll be testing margarita.
Is that what we're doing tomorrow?
Pre-made? No.
Oh, that's all hers.
Tomorrow. Yeah. See, tomorrow I still got all of these. I don't know if I'm going to have a Cabernet, or I already drank the Rumpus. The Rumpus was probably the best, or whatever this is. This is Argentine Malbec.
If you guys didn't see that one, it was really great because John just got drunker and drunker, and it got to the point at the end where I'm like, "All right, Dad, wrap it up. You're about to say some things. Let's go, bud."
To be fair, we did go about an extra 20 minutes.
Yeah.
We did. Does anybody know how to say this? Minervois. M-I-N-E-R-V-O-I-S. This is apparently some French wine.
Wiener.
Wiener. all right. I'll be drinking the I'll be drinking the wiener tomorrow at one.
That's a Megan trick.
Anyway, for all of you who were it's like I'm drinking now.
You got drunk and that's
all the alcohol is by the workplaces.
Oh yeah.
My gosh. Anyway. All right. Everybody wave. Thank you folks so much for watching. And we will see you here. Now I'll play this out.
Get ready to match the stars.